As a reporter, it's not only a plus to work in my hometown, like Kansas City, but it's also an added bonus to work at the station that I grew up watching, WDAF-TV4. And not far from Signal Hill, at 46th and Prospect, I spent lots of time there. It was my family's Mexican restaurant, the first one in Kansas City. I'm one of eight children, with an Irish father and a Mexican mother. My parents met after Dad graduated from Rocker's College, and they both sang in the Mexican fiestas and performed in the Kansas City Philharmonic Chorus. In our house, speaking Spanish, as well as dancing the Irish jig at the same time, it was normal. In fact, we celebrated St. Patrick's Day as if it was Christmas. And it was actually a family holiday in Ireland when my dad took us on a tour in a minivan that I met my future husband, Ian. Grade school at Christ the King, Bishop O'Hara High School, and UMKC helped shape my education, with a quick year at the University College of Dublin. While in college, I hosted a local cable show, and I worked at several radio stations, including WHB and Mix 93. It was back to Ireland, where I married my sweetheart, Ian, and we had a little baby boy named Kian. I worked in news, and I co-hosted a radio show on Radio Nova's Zoo Crew. But I missed the tall television towers of Kansas City, so it was back home as a reporter on a magazine show at KCPT Public Television. At the same time, I also reported, I hosted live shows like the St. Patrick's Day Parade, and I anchored at the NBC affiliate here in Kansas City for more than a decade. I also had a couple of bit parts in a couple of movies, like Paquita in Mr. and Mrs. Bridge, and I've also won a couple of Emmys along the way.
We had to fight for this story, we did it.
My most favorite was the one for a news series in the Dominican Republic, when I traveled with my brother as he performed surgery on kids. And speaking of kids, during this time, we also added two little girls to the family, Caitlin and Andrina. Life after NBC, I directed traffic for the morning show as the traffic reporter on the local CBS affiliate. Now, while at the same time, I worked as the news director at Star 102 Radio. It's been a very interesting trip to Signal Hill, but in 2002, I finally made it, and now I call Fox 4 home. And speaking of home, this is my home in South Kansas City. I live here with my husband and my three kids. Kian is our oldest son, and he's a local musician. Give him any instrument, and he'll play it. He's just like his dad, who's the lead singer with the Elders. And of course, the girls are very musical as well, Caitlin and Andrina. And between their studies, they get in on the family act.
Andrina and Caitlin.
Caitlin has hit the runway and added fashion modeling to her resume as she continues her studies at UMKC. Andrina is in Spain at the moment. She's studying abroad, journalism and mass communications. She also goes to UMKC. And Kian will now play with his father as the drummer with the Celtic rockers, the Elders.
So whether it's reporting for the evening news, filling in as an anchor, live shots for Fox National, or reporting for the morning show in all kinds of weather, it's a job I love to do.
And a weekly franchise called Pay It Forward is where I get a surprise, an unsuspecting but deserving recipient with $300. It makes my day. Most recently, though, I was the one who surprised live on the air when the co-chair of the St. Patrick's Day Parade, Jan Aylward, announced that I would be the Grand Marshal of the parade. What an honor. Working in my hometown, near my family, at the station I grew up watching, it can't get any better. Now that you've heard from me, I want to hear from you. Kathy.Quinn at WDAFTV4.com. Until next time, see ya!